Hello and welcome to the presentation of our solution for the Data Mining Cup 2020. My name is Philipp Funke.
And I'm Thomas Fritz.
We will explain to you how we created a solution for this year's Data Mining Cup and the model we used. To train the model, we tried to predict the number of orders per item in the last 2 weeks from a trimmed version of the given data. But for our predictions, we still had to use data from the entire 6-month period. That means we had to create all time-dependent features twice. Once for our training phase and once for our predictions. The first version had information from the 1st to the 166th day and the second version from the 1st to the 180th day. Inside this yellow box you can see two of the original files that came with our task, as well as files containing our custom features like the mean number of orders or the impact of a price change per item. Then we merged all those features into one dataset for our training phase, added our target feature, and sorted out all items which were not sold in these 166 days. After that, we partitioned the data into a set of training data and a set of test data for our models using ratios of 70% and 30%. After that, we assigned the correct data type to our features, as you can see in this note. From more than 100 custom-made features, we selected the 25 most significant and gave them to our model. We used a random forest model for our task, as we figured out it would work best on our data. In terms of hyperparameters, we chose to create 120 trees with a maximum depth of only 10 to reduce the influence of overfitting. This yellow node here is our generated model. After getting the result, we filtered out unnecessary attributes and used the fill node to set negative predictions to 0 and round fractional predictions using this statement. Now we could analyze our results. For the analysis, we used this node to calculate the turnover for the test and training data, which you can see here. You can also see that the mean total error is higher on the test data than on the training data. This is due to overfitting. To reduce the impact, we had to keep the distance between the errors as low as possible. After we created the model with the most turnover and the lowest distance between the errors, we could prepare our prediction for the simulation phase, which Thomas will explain to you now.
The prediction phase begins with a similar looking yellow box containing yet again all of our custom data files, but this time sampled from the first day up to the 180th. So we got data from the entire 6-month period in there, and no longer any test data to compare our model's predictions to. Again, we connect the features. In the filter, we had to rename some variables, so our model thinks they're like the ones from its training phase, and we also had to set their data types like we did previously. Without a test phase, we didn't need to partition the data. Instead, we just marked 100% for predictions. We could then connect the output of our type node to the random forest model we've trained earlier. After that, we filtered out all attributes except the ones for our submission, and again set negative predictions to 0 and rounded fractional predictions. The last step was to rename the target attribute and export the file with the formatting specified. I hope we could explain our approach well enough, and we want to thank you for your attention.